Let's talk about it, child, because there's a lot of controversy going on in the church. Kirk Franklin
Ooh.
is in hot water for a leaked recording. Now, Kirk's estranged son, Kerryon Franklin, took to social media to air out his father, who he claims mistreats him. In the video, you can hear the gospel star on a recorded phone conversation calling his son everything but a child of God. Now, after the audio hit several blogs, Kirk posted a video on social media explaining their toxic relationship, saying, "Recently, my son and I had an argument that he chose to record. I felt extremely disrespected in that conversation, and I lost my temper and I said words that are not appropriate. I am sincerely sorry to you all. I sincerely apologize." Now, I need to know what y'all are thinking about this one, because let's be clear, Big Mama used to curse y'all out in front of the church and nobody right. took away her right. Christian car. So, right.
yeah. Could I say something real quick?
Yeah, I'm gonna let you
yeah.
look. Let me take off my damn glasses for this one, because I've been following this. Look, I think people think that if you're a successful person, that you're a perfect person. And that's not the case. And even with being a spiritual person, people think if you're spiritual, you're supposed to be perfect. And the one thing I know about being famous and being a celebrity, just because you go out there and you make a name for yourself, that doesn't mean that trickles down to everybody. And everybody has family problems, family drama. Mm-hmm. Imagine if we heard what you and your mom went through, what you and your dad went mm-hmm. through, or what you and your brothers and sisters went through. So it's unfortunate, because I've been through this firsthand, where we all have problems and growing pains. And imagine if you recorded those moments and played them. Now they're there mm-hmm. forever. Sometimes you're supposed to just argue and it's going to fade away the next day or 3 weeks or 3 months. Mm-hmm. But now we live in a social media day and age where we record each other and we're having these personal issues with the world, and it's not for the world. So it's unfortunate. I think Kirk could have handled it better, because as a parent and as a man in this position, he's teaching us how to deal with situations like this. But he's a human too at the end of the day. I'm just saying, if you heard me and my dad go at it sometimes, you'd be like, these two niggas this close? I had to use that, because that's how it is. You'll be like, these dudes is that close to each other? Me and my dad go at it. But we love each other more than anybody on planet Earth. Mm. So this is just an unfortunate situation, because it sucks when all your family drama, you're dealing with it to the world, and all they have to do is comment on it. It sucks.
Mm-hmm.
Put my glasses back on.
For one, y'all know, like, I'm like the ratchet one out the group. But
my nigga, this is why
I'm ratchet.
So much.
Let's
so
get ratchet.
Give us the real
ratchet.
Let me just say, y'all, when I read that Kirk Franklin, you know, was getting out his body, I was so anxious to find the video, because, like, I'm just like, oh, I just can't wait to hear Kirk Franklin, like, going off. Like, that's how I felt. And when I heard the video, I'm like, I love Kirk Franklin even more. I just feel like, you know, like Romeo said, families have problems. Like, and he's a person. Like, he's not just, you know, a celebrity. You know, people
not
are,
Jesus.
Yeah, like right. People expect too much out of celebrities. They expect mm-hmm. to be perfect, like Romeo said. Like, so I was, you know, I was definitely into the video. I feel like we didn't even get to hear what his son was saying. We only heard Kirk's side. So there's no telling what the son said to make Kirk get like that. And I'm saying Kirk, like, I really know him. I feel like I know him now when I heard that video. Kirk, that's my
uncle. Well, my biggest thing was his son is 33 years old. So when he told his age, I said, at this point, you either need to go to therapy, or unfortunately, at your age, you have to leave the toxic situations alone. Mm-hmm. So for me, everybody knows I don't have the best relationship with my dad, but I still, and we've had some sensitive conversations, but I still would never go to the internet and tell our private family business and right. tarnish his legacy. I'm either going to go to therapy with him, or at 24, I'm going to say, you know what, we're toxic, let's just go separate ways. Mm-hmm. So I feel like his son handled that very immaturely and very poorly, but I do hope that they can fix it, because, you know, nobody wins when the family feuds.
Okay. That's yeah.
heard you, heard you.
Also, too, I feel like we constantly put these gospel singers, these pastors, these preachers, these evangelicals to a pedestal that's unrealistic, mm-hmm. and we forget that they are real people, that they're not holier than thou, you know, they're just like you and I. And so when you have moments like this, it should show you, like, those people are no different than you. They got the same problems that you got going on at home. So, you know, hopefully they work this out. You know, I really do feel bad for the child in this, because at the end of the day, he is a child. Even at 33, that's still, I consider that a child, okay? I consider that a child. I'm like, you know, we don't know what he's had to go through in that family structure, right, in that home. So what if he really was going through it and this was his only way for people to truly believe him and say, I'm living in a toxic environment? So I don't know. I'm not saying that's what it is, right, but I'm hoping that they can fix this.
But Tom, look, before we move on, you got to realize this is going through everyday life. They got kids where, yeah, if you're not famous, this is going on every day. Mm-hmm. I just feel this sucks, because when you are famous, we want to bring it to the media and they want to use it as a story. And that's going to make it harder, mm-hmm, for that child and that parent to mend that relationship.
Yep.
But this is happening in real life every day. People acting like it's new. It's not new.
Facts.
They just famous.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's just put to a bigger audience. That's all.
Yeah.
All I'm going to say is I'm hashtag can't cancel Kirk, period. Ever. We ain't doing that. Okay, y'all, there's more drama going on in Hollywood, so let's get into it. So this is the news that shook everybody over the weekend. It seems like Jennifer Lopez and Alex Rodriguez, can I say his name? Alex Rodriguez, are you the biggest hump of 2021, as TMZ reported that the couple called it quits after their four-year relationship. Now, several outlets said that the couple called it quits after a rumor swirled that A-Rod had been getting a little too friendly with Southern Charm star Madison LaCroix. Well, the couple put out a joint statement claiming that the reports were inaccurate and that they were working through some things. Meanwhile, J-Lo posted a video montage on social media to Sweetie's Pretty Bitch Freestyle, with videos of herself and blog headlines about the breakup seemingly trying to put the rumors to bed. Now, what do you guys think about this one? Because word at the lemonade stand is their relationship is hanging on by a thread.
Hey, I'll let y'all take this one, because I ain't stepping in nobody's personal relationship. Take it.
Okay.
Now, my brother.
Let me just ask this one question. Why do people care? That's what I'm, why do y'all care so much about if they're together or not? How does it affect you in any way, shape, or form?
I think people really were hoping that they would make it. They seem like the perfect couple. So I think that's why they came. I felt like I was invested. I was like, oh my gosh, this is a powerful
There's no such thing.
I hope that
the key word there is they seem like a perfect couple. Yeah. That's the key word.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
There's no such thing.
I was gonna say, y'all keeping it real cute, because like, let's take the celebrity out. Even black folks look out their blinds to see if their neighbors are arguing in the streets. So while everybody trying to be politically correct, we care.
Right.
I care. I was shook. I was texting. So stop being cute about it. We care. It got everybody shook, and hopefully they can work it out, because we in their business.
Yeah, well, yeah, I would say this. If they don't make it, I really hope that she gets back with Diddy. Like, I want to see.
Let it go.
Tom, look at me, Tom. Look at me in the eyes, okay?
I'm looking.
Look at me. You just made me want to bring up a point, my brother. Y'all seen, as soon as they said that lady was getting a divorce from her husband, how all them dudes start sliding in her DMs, even putting public little messages out there. His best friends, his homies saying, J-Lo, I'm ready.
No.
That's crazy.
It's always the homies. After you break up with the kid, it's always the homies.
I can't rock with that. Maybe this was a punk, like you said, Leah. This was a punk to see who's real and who's not. Maybe they playing everybody.
Back to the street. Okay. Listen.
We got any more tea? We got any more tea?
J-Lo so bad, I'll date her.
Period.
I'm saying she would date her.
I would. Oh, my God.
Period.
She's beautiful. I love her.